Hello students, today we are back to our earlier chapter that we were revising from health and diseases, non-infectious diseases. Infectious diseases caused by some vector like mosquito, flies and waterborne, airborne diseases. We all have seen how by direct contact also some diseases are spreading. But certain diseases which are non-infectious, that we are going to discuss today and revise once again. Diseases which do not occur through any of the infection from outside, it is not caused, and body contact also is not responsible for these type of diseases, they are termed as non-infectious diseases. Even if you come in contact with these patients, we are not going to get contracted with these diseases. Certain examples of non-infectious diseases in the society commonly observed are cancer, diabetes, and heart diseases. Nowadays is very common. First of all, let us discuss about cancer. You see, uncontrolled and abnormal cell growth. You all know our bodies are made up of cells. So in some area, some part of the body, when there is abnormal and unlimited, uncontrolled growth of cells is occurring, in that case, a group or a lump of cells or cancerous cells is growing in one area, and that is called as malignant tumor. It gets converted into a lump or a group of cells, but that is malignant tumor. It is growing in size and causing disturbance to other body functioning. Cancer can occur in various organs like lungs, mouth, then stomach, breast, uterus, skin, and tissues like blood also can be suffering from this disease. You see, in blood also it is seen that RBC, WBC and platelets are already there, the blood cells. When some of them start growing malignantly, very fast, uncontrolled growth of some or the other cell, that will obviously damage the functioning of blood and its smooth working. And that can cause blockage also. If too much WBC are growing in the blood, in that case, you can imagine what all things can happen. It can block the other cells' growth. It can block the free-flowing blood through the veins and arteries. And we have to take treatment for that. Now, certain reasons are also there for cancer. Though it is non-infectious, some reasons are there that can lead to cancer. Earlier it was not very common, but nowadays we find it very commonly that cancer patients are growing in number. Here you see certain lifestyle habits are also responsible. For example, like tobacco consumption. People who have the habit of eating tobacco, chewing tobacco all the day, and keeping in their mouth, then gutkha, chewing, smoking of cigarette and bidis, alcoholism, those who drink alcohol, lack of fiber content food. Many children nowadays do not like fibrous food. Whatever mother is cooking, the vegetables and all, they do not like. But you see, if fruits and leafy vegetables you will not eat, this fibrous material, if you are not eating, your body is not going to be healthy. Some or the other part, it can develop a cancer. Excessive consumption of junk food. You all love to eat junk food, pizza, burger, and noodles nowadays, but the chemicals they have added in it to enhance the taste. You like it because it tastes very good to your tongue, but it is definitely going to cause damage to your digestive system because all the chemicals are like Ajinomoto and other chemicals, preservatives, they reach your stomach and they cause harm to the inner lining of your digestive system. That can also lead to cancer. And some of the many possible reasons, heredity may also be one of the reason. In case of diabetes, mostly it is seen that from heredity, from your parents, you also can suffer from that disease. Okay. Then certain symptoms of cancer, if you discuss their chronic cough, all the time coughing, then hoarse voice, difficulty in swallowing. In that case, you find that the smokers or tobacco and hookah chewers, they must have developed a cancerous cell, malignant group of cells in the throat area, in your esophagus, the food pipe, and therefore swallowing food material, drinking water, everything becomes very tough for these patients, and these are certain signs that you have a certain problem, maybe cancerous cells growing in that area. Then incurable scar and inflammation in certain parts of your body, inside the digestive system, ulcer, all the time occurring ulcer because of acidity and all, these cause inflammation, swelling, and incurable scars on your inner body parts, organs. This can also lead to cancerous cell developing, growing over there, because damaged cell again will try to recorrect and cover that area. So extra cells can grow over there and they could be cancerous. The lump in the breast, unexplained weight loss. Sometimes some people face some lump, gut, what you call in your common language, that can be felt in some part of your body, or suddenly weight loss also can occur. In that case, you should immediately visit a master's degree doctor and get yourself tested for your these cancerous cells growing in some part of the body or not. So every year one time complete body checkup is necessary for such reasons, because we never know what's going on inside the body. Then another disease that we can discuss today is about diabetes. Diabetes is related to your blood sugar level. Okay, the hormone insulin, the hormone named insulin produced in the pancreas. What is the hormone name? Insulin, which is produced in the pancreas. You all have studied the digestive system in your earlier class, so you know where the pancreas are located, near your stomach and liver. And this pancreas are responsible for releasing proper amount of this hormone named insulin. So this controls the level of sugar glucose in the blood. What is the work of this hormone? It is working in controlling sugar or glucose in our blood. So you see, this insulin hormone is also very important for your proper body growth. If this blood sugar level increases, then you will be termed as to have diabetes. If insulin is secreted in low quantity, why this can happen? If insulin is secreted in low quantity, glucose level cannot be controlled. This disorder is called as a diabetes. Now, sugar patients have lot of problems. If they get a cut in their any body part, the blood will ooze out and stop, and that can lead to loss of blood in the body and of course hemoglobin. Then in another case, it can create pressure on the heart for pumping, and that will result into heart problems. So diabetes patient have to either take artificial this hormone insulin to be injected in their bodies to control the sugar in their blood. Otherwise, they will face a lot of problems. Sudden weight loss, sudden weight gain. These all things can happen to their bodies, and they will be always feeling very dizzy and lazy. Now, certain symptoms that will tell you that your body is suffering from diabetes or not. You have to go for urination frequently. Again and again, you have to go to toilet at night also, and increase obesity or weight loss. Sudden weight loss or weight gain. These are certain signs of diabetes, or constant very frequent urination is also another sign of diabetes. In those case, if you have such problems, you should go to the doctor, test your blood for diabetes. If there is more amount of sugar in your blood, it will be tested positive that you do suffer from diabetes, and medicines will be given to you or insulin injections to control this diabetes in your body, because blood is only one factor that is reaching each and every part, each and every cell of your body and doing the work of transportation. And if it is getting defected, your whole body will show the effect. Now, there are certain reasons of diabetes, not only that insulin production is reduced by pancreas. Why it must have reduced, that is also one reason. Heredity, first thing it could be. Then obesity, too much eating and not doing exercise and sitting and increasing your weight. That could be one reason. Lack of physical exercise. Those who are suffering from diabetes, doctor tell them the best medicine is to do lot of walking and other exercises. And too much of mental stress. Sometimes you see some people are too much in tension because of their life problems. In that case, they can suffer from diabetes. So good lifestyle is the only key to your good health. Okay, that is the main factor for keeping you healthy. The third disease that today we are going to discuss is heart diseases. Heart diseases, I told you, if blood, your heart is actually a pumping machine in your body to pump blood, and exchange of blood, pure impure blood is being exchanged. We are going to study in your further classes the working of the heart also, so you will understand much better. Actually, heart disease, you see, efficiency of the heart decreases due to decreased blood supply, and thereby oxygen also and nutrient supply to the heart muscles. Due to this, heart has to perform more work that leads to stress on it. This may cause heart attack. If more pressure is coming on the heart for pumping, in that case, the heart valves can get damaged. There are valves in the heart for transportation, passing of blood, that can get damaged and heart attack can occur. If someone has heart attack, immediate consultation of doctor and treatment is necessary, because heart failure will lead to death. One should not ignore these symptoms: severe chest pain, pain in the shoulder, mostly the left side. Neck and arms, cramps in the hand, uneasiness and tremors, shaking of the body. So these are certain signs of heart attack. So reasons of heart attack are many. You have bad habits like smoking, alcoholism, diabetes can be coming from your heredity also. Hypertension, too much of tension taking habit. Obesity, eating too much and increasing your weight. Lack of physical exercise is very much important factor for many of the diseases in the body. Heredity could be sometimes, and mental stress, anger and anxiety are the reasons that can result into heart diseases. So to avoid them, I think the best way is to limit your eating habit and do more and more exercise to keep yourself fit and fine. Then in case of heart disease, the doctors will suggest certain remedies like angioplasty, bypass surgery. Bypass surgery, what they are doing, whatever pipes or the blood veins, they are passing blood to the heart. If they are getting blocked, in that case, they will put some another blood veins and arteries from your own body. They will remove from your thigh or chest part and they will add another bypass way for the flow of blood to the heart, because blockages do not allow proper amount of blood to reach the heart. That can also cause a heart attack. Then open heart surgery is also being done, but very few times nowadays. Heart implant is also possible, but within some time limit after the heart failure, this is possible, and donor of heart should also be ready, means available. Then installation of stent, wherever there is a blockage in the blood circulatory system, stent means artificial, medically made wire-like structure is being made, and that is passed through the same portion, and the mesh at the end is allowed to open so that this stent will open and release the blockage from that area. And installation of pacemaker is also suggested in some cases if the heart is not at all working. So first aid for heart disease is very important, and immediate doctor's care is very important in such case. So we should discuss certain other topics related to medicine and its misuses, and some low cost medicines like generic medicines also are available, and how we can use them and why we should use them. All these things we shall again take up a short revision about these topics in our next class. Okay, so bye all of you. Thank you.